and welcome to yet another broadcast of the ECMS News. I'm Summer.
And I'm Cynthia. Join us for an in-depth look at what's happening at El Cerrito Middle School for this week of October 10th.
First off, in the wild world of sports, both our girls and boys basketball teams won last week's matchup against River Heights.
The girls won by 15, while the boys cruised to a 20-point victory.
Both games were physical and hard-fought, but the Red Hawk team simply had too much talent to be denied.
Please enjoy some video and interviews from the game.
We're here with Lady Hawks head coaches, Steve Case and Mr. Jeremy Shaw. What do you guys thought of the big victory last week at Andre Ramirez?
That was last week. We're 0-0 right now. We need to win this today.
Sure. Very stoic, very strong. I mean, I love it. Have you heard anything about River Heights?
They look big, but I think we're going to out-athlete them when we got a run up.
I like that. What do you think the focus is on player-wise for your team this week?
Who needs to make this game?
Yes.
Well, Queen, Steve Allar, our all-star, he's got two firsts. So
All right. Thank you, gentlemen, for your time and good luck. Let's go right on.
I'm up front.
All right. Cool. Hey. All right. Big victory last week. Okay. What are your thoughts?
Good W. We're going to get back this Tuesday at El Cerrito Middle School. We're going to get one again.
All right, very good. Have you heard anything about this green team?
I heard they have a lot of big guys, but I don't think they're a really good team, but we'll see.
Okay, hey, you can only take care of who's in front of you. I think you guys will do all right. Go Red Hawks and good luck.
All right, thank you.
Thank you. Hey, Red Hawks, we're here today talking to boys basketball coach, Mr. Tony Ruiz. Tony, big victory last week at Augie. Your thoughts?
It was a good game. Boys fought hard. Got a little scary there at the end, but we pulled out the W, and it was a good win for us.
I thought the boys played very strong. I thought they were confident. I thought they came in with a definite game plan, and you guys took care of business. What are your thoughts on River Heights this week?
Burley, I don't know anything about them. I think I do know they took that L against Citrus. So we'll find out today, but I like our chances.
Okay, all right. Good luck today, and thanks for talking to us.
Yes, thank you, sir.
All right.
Go Red Hawks.
Both teams are back at it as the Citrus Hills Jaguars come to town to do battle in the Red Hawk Arena this Tuesday.
Come on out and support our student athletes as they try to strengthen their grip on first place.
Sticking with sports, our cross-country team travels to Mount SAC this Friday to take on that legendary course.
The news desk will have pictures and results of the renowned race of upcoming broadcasts.
Moving on to the making money moves, please enjoy some opportunities to put the fun in fundraising.
First, do you wish you had come to El Cerrito to gear to our school spirit while raising money for activities?
The Fan Cloth Fundraising Sale is going on until October 17th.
Click on the QR code behind us or go to the webpage, whichever is actually behind us. We just never know.
Looking for other ways to raise money for El Cerrito? Well, the Bash Fundraiser may be right up your alley.
It goes on from October 10th, and our El Cerrito Silent Disco is on October 19th.
For more information and infinite deals, go to mybooster.com and get started.
The goal is to waste $20,000, so let's get moving.
Moving on from gouging folks for money, let's talk philanthropy.
Link is selling bracelets and having pink elves every Friday this month.
Also, Link and ASB have teamed up with the Support Sisters to host an on-campus combat cancer walk/run on Wednesday, October 19th, right after school.
$10 gets you an admission and to the run and a snazzy medal.
Most importantly, it helps the fight against breast cancer.
Let's be involved. Be the cure.
Speaking of getting involved, Avid is presenting the Kick of the College Week this week.
Activities during 5th will include college awareness survey,
door decorating contest,
teacher scavenger hunt,
mascot match,
and college football and college helmet decorating.
Thank you, Avid, for cultivating our desire for a higher education.
And finally, as the Halloween dance gets closer,
all students wishing to purchase a dance ticket must have a 2.0 GPA with no Fs on the quarter one interim report card.
And let's hope you qualify it this year. The haunted house looks to be incredible. It will be a shame if you miss out.
That's our broadcast, because that's the way the news goes. Thank you for watching.
We'll return next week, but until then, y'all have a good day. Have a great day.
You don't tell me what to do.
I'm just a bachelor. I'm looking for a partner.